I'm Tony Voltage, singer of Underground Alliance, a punk band from East LA.
Rockabilly say, you do everything on your own. You're raised with respect. You're raised with how to treat a woman. You're raised to be your own man.
The ladies are just as tough as the men are.
We all like come from the same background in a way.
You have your ways, you don't need anyone else.
It has to do with the Pachuco era, the old fashioned, big pompadours, the cars.
Just get into it, lost.
Let's take a trip down with you!
Style, music, fashion, and art. Creativity, inventiveness, and diversity characterize the ethos of East Los Angeles. From the 1940s to the present, from the GI generation to the millennials, young people from East Los have shaped their identities through aesthetics, ideologies, and diverse forms of expression. Distinguished by a multiplicity of styles and subcultures that overlap and intermingle, youth in East Los Angeles have been tastemakers and trendsetters in American pop culture for over 80 years. Youth culture in East LA, a predominantly Chicano and Latino area of Los Angeles, reflects fashion and style, but also embraces music scenes and is associated with artistic movements. Often considered to be outside of mainstream narratives and visual identities, and set against the backdrop of important social movements in the post-war period, youth culture in East LA intersects with countercultural discourse over the past 8 decades. Sociologist Mike Brake states, "What is central to any examination of youth culture is that it is not some vague structural monolith appealing to those roughly under 30, but is a complex kaleidoscope of several subcultures of different age groups, yet distinctly related to the class position of those in them. Subcultures arise as attempts to resolve collectively experienced problems resulting from contradictions in the social structure, and they generate a form of collective identity from which an individual identity can be achieved outside that ascribed by class, education, and occupation. Some genres and styles prevalent in East LA have included pachucos, cholos, bikers, jetters, punks, new wavers, rockeros, riot girls, hip-hop, breakers, party crews, disco, wild style, cha-chas, ravers, emos, rockabilly, chipsters, midnight riders, skaters, and more. Similar to working-class youth groups in places such as Britain, young people in East LA have been subject to categorization as juvenile delinquents, and as ethnic minorities in the U.S. have been further diminished by racial stereotypes. Reinforced by negative, alarmist portrayals in the media, they've been objectified by their interpersonal cultural signifiers.
Sometimes you gotta kill for your barrio, just to keep up your reputation.
Barrio means neighborhood, and it is for this, the reputation of the neighborhood, that they are ready to kill and willing to die. Gang members bear permanent insignias. Tattoos proclaiming where they're from and what they stand for.
You guys don't understand because you're different from us. How are we different from you?
Because you guys ain't gangsters. You guys don't know what we're going through or
you guys
whatever.
Don't have people going up to you every day asking you where you're from. You guys don't have people drive by in your house.
But you chose to get in the gang. You said you wanted to be in the gang. No one forced you to.
Hey, have you and your girls ever, like, killed anybody? Do you feel guilty about it?
As with their British counterparts, East LA youth channeled their frustrations through creative forms of self-expression. In the post-war period, East LA youth developed styles that resonate with British working-class subcultures such as teddy boys, mods and rockers, and punks. Or have appropriated British genres, transforming them for local contexts.
It is the bomb, the bomb, the bomb, the bomb, the bomb.
Stuart Hall and Tony Jefferson have stated in their volume on youth culture that its appearance as an emergent category is one of the most striking and visible manifestations of social change in the post-war period. As a social class, youth signify the promise and potential for the future. With the national portrait shifting to majority-minority, class structures and economic divides contributing to the prevalence of subcultures in East Los Angeles may dissipate over time. But if we separate culture from economic class, we are left with ingenuity. As tastemakers, young people from East LA continue to be bold, think outside the box, and question the status quo.
It doesn't matter much to me. Let me take you down, 'cause I'm going to Strawberry.